No, I stopped it in time. Yes, she's all right, but she's starting to make my job difficult. Look, she's not that easy to look after. Don't worry, I'll keep my eye on her.
Family to me. Are your parents still alive?
Not to me.
Well, this world is hard enough without trying to face everything alone. So if you want to talk to anybody, my grandchildren tell me that I'm not a bad listener.
You know, Mike is a very, very lucky guy. I've told him that before. As a matter of fact, I think that I will go find him and tell him again right now.
Hey, where'd you get that bruise on your arm?
Oh, I haven't had a chance to even tell you the latest.
I'm almost afraid to ask what.
Oh, well, it's nothing, really. I was sort of mugged yesterday.
What do you mean, sort of?
Well, I was down on the pier, and this guy tried to grab my purse.
And of course you didn't give it to him, right?
Well, I would have. It's just that he had his arms around me and his hand over my mouth, and I couldn't give it back to him.
Well, then what happened?
I'm not sure, really. I think that somebody came up behind him and grabbed him, because all of a sudden he just let me go, and I ran away.
Well, did you get a look at either one of them?
No. No, but I think it was just a simple purse snatching. I mean, that happens all the time down on the pier. I wonder who rescued me.
Me. Are you sure it's the same guy?
It was definitely the same guy.
All right, that does it. Who are you calling?
Roman.
He won't be able to do anything. There's got to be something he can do. We've got to get this guy before he gets me.
Diana, what's the problem?
Do you remember the guy that I told you about before, the guy with the braid?
The one that you thought you saw the night your fiancé was killed, yeah.
No, the one that I know I saw. Well, I saw him again today on my way home. He's following me.
Was there a confrontation?
No, he just followed me.
Well, he's obviously after her. It's just a matter of time before he gets to her.
But we really don't have any way to prove it, right?
Look, okay, Kayla, we can't prove that he's responsible for anything even remotely illegal.
He's stalking her. That's got to be enough to arrest someone.
Look, and I wish there was something I could do, but if I go out and arrest this guy without due cause, it's only going to hurt us. We got to wait for him to slip up.
Well, in the meantime, there must be something you can do to help her.
Actually, there is.
I knew it.
I can post a guard outside her door.
Okay. That's what you want to do?
Settled. There'll be an armed guard outside your door 24 hours a day. Provided you stay in here, you're going to be safe, but if you get outside, you're on your own. Can I use your phone to call headquarters?
Sure. Right. There's got to be something more we can do.
Well, if there's one thing I've learned, it's that police play by the rules. Their hands are tied.
Well, somebody's got to do something.
Believe me, I know that.
I know how awful this must be for you, Diana.
Yeah, the worst part of it is not knowing why. You know, I've got to find out why I'm in the middle of all this.
I know, it's a frightening thing feeling hunted. Always looking over your shoulder, not knowing who's on your side.
It's a little difficult to know who to trust.
Yeah.
Jack Devereaux?
Okay.
Miss Devereaux?
What's going on? What's the guard for? You okay?
I'm fine, Jack. Hi.
Kayla, tell me the truth. Is Steve Johnson coming after you? Is he threatening you?
The guard isn't for me, Jack. He's protecting Diana.
Diana? Are you all right?
Yes, I'm fine. It's just a precaution. I thought that someone was following me.
Well, listen, if there's anything I can do to help, just let me know.
Thank you. Jack, I don't remember you saying you were going to stop by.
No, well, I thought I'd come by and surprise you and ask you out to dinner. Thought you might enjoy a night out.
This is Mike Horton to see Miss Colvin.
Let him in.
What the devil is going on here?
I'll explain later. Kayla, why don't you go ahead with Jack? Mike is here now and he can stay with me. I couldn't ask him to do that.
You don't have to ask.
Thanks, Mike. Are you ready to go?
Sure. I'll be going on. Well, have a good time. Don't worry about me.
Listen, I hope everything works out for you. We'll see you later.
Yeah. Bye. Bye.
Do you want to fill me in on what's going on here?
Do you remember my friend with the braid?
Of course I remember.
Well, he's back. He's been following me.
Damn it. I can't believe this is still going on.
And I think it's going to continue to go on until we do something about it.
Okay. Okay, I know that look. What are you thinking?
I think that I have come up with a way to put an end to this once and for all.
Chicken out on you?
The rope. Did you bring the rope?
Yeah. I came prepared.
Here, do you need help?
Yeah, we better do this while he's napping. No, you take care of what you gotta do.
Darn it.
Nothing?
No.
What about
some bills, some change? No wallet, nothing.
No wallet?
Not even a credit card.
He doesn't look like the kind of guy who would carry a library card with him either.
So much for that part of the plan.
Well, looks to me like we're going to have to wait until Sleeping Beauty gets up to get some answers from him.
I'll have someone relieve you at 0600.
Thank you.
Mm-hmm.
Night.
So you want me just to stick around here for a little while or what?
No. Well, why don't I just check and see if Diana's all right and you can go, okay?
All right.
Well, she's gone.
You're kidding me.
No.
I don't believe it.
Well, what could have happened to her? The guard said no one left.
I don't know. Maybe she's upstairs. Look, I'm going to go check the window
now. Oh, that's got to be her. Hello?
Hey, sweetness.
Steve, I can't believe it's you.
It's really me, baby.
It's so good to hear your voice. I've been so worried about you.
I've been thinking about you, too.
Well, how are you? Where are you? Are you all right?
I'm fine. Listen, we can't talk long. The phone might still be tapped.
No, it's not. Don't worry about that. We can talk. They took the tap off.
How can we be sure?
Well, something wonderful happened. Roman's on our side. He believes your story.
What? Are you serious?
Yeah, he's here right now. He knows all about the FBI and Hopkins and everything. So you see, you can come home. He'll make sure that you're protected.
Well, that sounds good, baby. I can't believe it.
So where are you?
I'm in Salem.
Well, great. Where are you? I'll come get you.
No, you stay there. I'll come over to your place later tonight.
Well, Steve, you should come through my window. Come on the roof. There's a guard outside my front door.
A guard? What? They got someone protecting you from me?
No, it's for Diana.
All right. Well, listen, I better go now.
Be careful.
I will, baby. And thank you. You tell your brother thanks, too, huh?
I will.
Sweetness.
Yeah?
Listen, when I come over tonight, I want you to be alone.
Details, Kayla. I want to know everything he said.
He said he's okay. Oh, thank heavens, I'm all right.
What else?
Well, that he's coming home. He's coming here. Tonight.
Well, not bad for a couple of beginners, huh? Got this guy right where he wanted him. You okay?
Yeah.
Why are you shaking? I mean, he's the guy who's in trouble, not us.
Because I'm finally going to know the truth about James.
Come on, now, don't get carried away.
I'm not. But it's true. I'm finally going to know why he was lying to me.
Well, I'm not saying that you're wrong. Just don't get your hopes up, huh? We got to wait and see what this guy has to say first.
Emergency. This is the night watchman over at my storage. I think I just walked in on a kidnapping.
How long until he wakes up and he's able to talk?
I don't know. I didn't exactly give him a measured dose of chloroform, but it shouldn't be too long.
Hello. Just a minute, please. It's for you.
Yeah, Brady here. All right, on my way. That's headquarters. Seems there's some kind of a kidnapping or mugging or something going on at Acme Storage.
Where's that?
Yeah, it's not far from here. Night watching, called in, mumbled some sort of garbled message, so I better check it out.
Roman, there's just one more thing.
All right, save it. I'll be back.
Roman.
Listen, I gotta go, sis.
No, I don't want you to come back. Not until tomorrow.
Kayla, look.
No, look, I haven't seen Steve for over a week. Just give us this one night alone together. Just this one night, please.
Johnson is a fugitive. He's got warrants on him in 6 states, including this one. He's mixed up in something real.
I know that. And I will make sure that he turns himself into you personally, all right?
Can't do that. I'm sorry, honey.
Roman, just for 12 hours, will you just not be a cop? Just be my brother?
All right.
Thank you.
So you want to spend some time with Johnson on your own, fine. Let me give you a little advice. Keep him here. Don't let him put one foot outside. For his own good.
All right. Thanks again.
Those big baby blues. I'd like to see a smile on them.
Too.
Did you bring the truth serum?
Come on, you've been reading too many comic books. I already told you there's no such thing as truth serum.
Well, the sodium pentothal or whatever you call it.
It doesn't even mean he's going to answer any questions. The most it's going to do is relax him so he lets down his guard. Unless, of course, he's as afraid of needles as I am, then we can scare the truth out of him.
You're afraid of needles?
Not when I'm giving them. Oh. Close enough. Okay, Sleeping Beauty. Oh, nap time is over. It's time to answer some questions here. What?
Who are you? Answer me. Who are you? What's your name?
Answer.
Why have you been following me?
Who are you?
I'm the one you've been following.
I don't know you. I've never seen you before.
You're lying to me, Diana,
take it easy.
He's been lying to me, and I want to know the truth.
Diana, we aren't going to get anywhere this way. Now, calm down, okay? All right. I'm not going to yell at you. I'm just going to listen. I want to know what your name is, I want to know why you're following Diana, and I want to know what you want from her. I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not following her. I don't even know who she is.
That's a lie.
Diana, let me. No, I don't believe you, pal. It's the truth. I wasn't following her.
If you weren't following me, then how did we get you in here?
You know, this is a deserted warehouse. And the only people that are here are you, me, and her. And we're not telling anybody else you're here, and you can't. So we got a lot of time to get to know each other.
Here's your choice.
Either you give us some straight answers, or I let her at you.
Who are you working for? Who's paying you?
Nobody's paying me. I was just going out for a walk.
And you just strolled into an abandoned warehouse?
I came in here to take a... to see if there was a men's room, okay?
Right. This is the first place I'd look.
What do you know about Hans?
Hans who?
What do you know about the computer disk? What do the formulas on it mean?
I don't know anything about any formulas. Look, lady, you're out of my league. I'm just an ordinary Joe. I don't even know how to use a computer.
Are you going to stick to that story?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Give him the sodium pentothal.
Never leave home without it.
How are you about injections, buddy? You know, they scare the hell out of me, all those prickly needles and stuff going through your skin. Oof, it's real scary. Well, one dose of sodium pentothal coming up.
Hey, man, get away from me with that thing.
This is gonna make you tell the truth.
You know what? You don't even get a lollipop afterwards.
Drop it. Drop the hypo, Mike. Come on, put it down.
What are you doing here, Roman?
Funny, I was just gonna ask you the same thing. He's clean.
The hell he is.
Easy. Listen, you stay right where you are. All right? Let's have it.
I didn't do anything.
Hey, you're going to get your chance to talk. Did you?
Roman, this is the guy.
One at a time, please. Just one at a time.
Roman, this is the guy that we were looking for. This is the guy that keeps tailing Diana.
I don't know what he's talking about. I don't even know who she is.
This is the man who was outside James' lab the night...
I figured that much out already.
Hey, look. These two people tied me up, knocked me out. They're crazy.
Want to press charges?
What?
Hey, are you out of your mind, Roman?
They admitted what they did. You can press charges if you like.
No, that's all right. They probably just made a mistake. The lady's mixed up.
Sure about that?
Yeah. Maybe she just, she doesn't know who I am. It was a mistake.
Just forget the whole thing then, huh?
Yeah, right. Can I go?
There's the door.
Do you have any idea who you just let walk out of here?
Probably the guy we've been looking for, yeah.
Then why?
I don't know what kind of movies the two of you have been going to, but that is about the dumbest stunt I have ever seen.
Roman, we had him right here.
And he had you. You're just lucky you didn't press charges.
Don't you realize who that man is?
That's why he didn't press any charges, because he is who you say he is. He can't go to court and stand up to any questions.
Well, then why? Why would you ever let him walk out?
Because I've got nothing to charge him with, Diana.
But he's the one. He's the one who's been following me.
Prove it, then. Prove it.
I can't.
We could have proved it, Roman, if you gave us a chance to interrogate the guy.
You were going to interrogate him?
Yeah.
And what were you going to do if you couldn't answer your questions? You gonna kill him?
No, of course not.
Beat him up, huh? Just punch him around, rough him up a little.
All right, what's your point here?
He knows you, Diana. And he knows you're a doctor. And he knows he was a lot safer here than he would ever be in my precinct.
I can't believe it. I can't believe we had him right here. And you just let him walk out.
Why don't you do me a real big favor, all right? Leave the police work to the cops. Now, both of you, why don't you just go on home and forget about playing junior commando before you get yourself in real trouble?
All right. We took a chance. And it didn't work. But at least we did something. Come on, Diana.
All right, I didn't see it coming. It's hard to see it coming when someone sneaks up behind you with chloroform and knocks you out. What's the bottom line? The bottom line is my cover's blown. She knows who I am. I can't protect her anymore. What? You sure that's what you want me to do?